Hi friends, good morning. Next video in our series, that is distinguish between amphids and phasmids. Friends, what is our question? Friends, distinguish between amphids and phasmids. Friends, amphids and phasmids. Friends, what are these two? These amphids and phasmids are the sensory organs of phylum Nematoda. Friends, phylum Nematoda, you may call it as Nemathelminthes, you may call it as Aschehelminthes. Friends, you know, nematodes are pseudocoelomates. This is only the phylum, friends, which have pseudocoelom. Okay? So these amphids and phasmids are the sensory organs of phylum Nematodes. These are present in the animals of the phylum Nematoda, friends. These are sensory organs. Now you have to differentiate, friends. What are amphids and what are phasmids? You know, both are sensory organs, but their location, their function is different in different animals, in different nematodes, friends. See, friends, amphids are present at the anterior end or at the oral region, friends. Amphids are present at the anterior end of the organisms of the nematodes or at the oral end, whereas phasmids are present at the posterior end. Friends, here there is a trick, friends. A stands for anterior, like that you have to remember. P for posterior. Amphids are present at the anterior end of the nematodes, whereas phasmids are present at the posterior end of the nematodes. That is the first difference, friends. Come to second one, friends. Amphids are chemoreceptors. Friends, they receive the signals of the chemicals. Amphids are the chemoreceptors, whereas phasmids are glandulosensory receptors or glandulosensory structures. Friends, once again, amphids are chemoreceptors. Friends, AC, you have to remember it, friends. Amphids are chemoreceptors. Phasmids are glandulosensory, PG, post-graduate, you have to remember, friends. Phasmids are glandulosensory structures. Next, friends. Amphids present in class Ephasmidea. Friends, here you see, phylum Nematoda is divided into two classes, friends. Ephasmidea and Phasmidea. Amphids are present in Ephasmidea. Friends, A means without. Without phasmids. See, it indicates, friends, means nematodes which do not have phasmids are included in the class Ephasmidea. Means they have amphids, friends. So A means without, Phasmidea means phasmids. So these amphids are present in class Ephasmidea, whereas phasmids are present in class Phasmidea. See, friends, they are present in class Phasmidea. Next, another important difference, friends. Amphids are present, or they are well developed in free living animals. See, nematodes are of two types, friends. Some are free living nematodes, some are parasite. Majority are the parasite, but some are free living, friends. Amphids are present in free living animals and they are well developed in free living nematodes. Whereas phasmids are present in parasites and they are well developed in parasites. For example, you see, friends, Trichinella and Trichurus. Friends, Trichinella and Trichurus have what, friends? Amphids. Come to phasmids, friends. You know, Ascaris, it is roundworm, friends. It is a parasite which lives in the small intestine of man. It is a monogenetic parasite. Next, Ankylostoma, it is hookworm, friends. Next, Enterobius, okay, this is pinworm, friends. So these three are parasites. So phasmids are well developed in parasites. What are those parasites? Ascaris, Ankylostoma, Enterobius. Whereas amphids are present in free living animals. What are they? Trichinella and Trichurus. Once again, friends, distinguish between amphids and phasmids. Amphids and phasmids are the sensory structures of the phylum Nematoda. Amphids are present in the oral region or at the anterior end of the body. Amphids are chemoreceptors. Amphids are present in class Ephasmidea. Amphids are well developed in free living nematodes. Aphids are present in well-developed in free-living nematodes. Next, friends, aphids are present in Trichinella and Trichurus. Example, you have to write, friends, Trichinella and Trichurus. At the same time, friends, come to phasmids. Phasmids are present at the posterior end of the nematodes, a posterior end of the body. Next, friends, these are glandulosensory structures. Glandulosensory structures, friends, they are present in class Phasmidia. Okay, friends, they are well developed in parasitic nematodes. They are well developed in parasitic nematodes. Example, friends, you have to write Ascaris, Ankylostoma, and Enterobius. Okay, friends, this is about the distinguish between or difference between what, friends? Aphids and phasmids. What are aphids and phasmids, friends? They are the sensory organs of phylum Nematoda. Okay, friends, thank you. Good day.